Hi Scorpio, welcome to Mirake the Tribe. My name is Ayushi and this is going to be for Scorpio Sun Moon Rising for the month of November 2018. Let's see what are the messages coming in for Scorpio Sun Moon Rising for the month of November 2018. Messages for Scorpio for November 2018. Sun Moon Rising. Messages for Scorpio. November 2000. Okay. So bottom of the deck is the Hierophant, which is the opposite sign, which is the Taurus sign for the Scorpio. And then the other card that flipped out for you was Two of Wands. So you are looking forward, you have completed your journey, there is something coming to an end, and with that a new something new is about to begin. Now you are standing at a crossroad, you don't know which path to take, which way to go, and you are looking for guidance from a guru or a spiritual master or someone who can guide you. It is also requiring you a lot of strength to you will need to gather a lot of courage to take whatever path that you want to take. But you have a lot of experience because of the life that you have led and the experiences that you have had. So you are very mature now, and you are also having some spiritual insight. That's what I'm getting. And also you might have a key to something very significant in your life. So you might have a plan and you know how to execute it. So you have an idea how to execute something or how to do something that you you never had before. So that is what I'm getting here. This is for Scorpio Sun, Moon and Rising for the month of November 2018. Ten card Celtic Cross. One last shuffle. Okay. So let's lay down the cards now. The first card out is the Death card, which is the Scorpio card. You are definitely going through some transformation, Scorpio. So you can be elevating from one level to next level, and you are taking your previous ideas, previous whatever that you had done before, whatever you had experienced before, you are thinking about all those things and you are planning something new. You don't want to do same thing again and again because you feel that I have to find a new way. I need to do things differently. So you need to change a lot of things about your life, and you know this. So in order to rebuild yourself, you want to be different now. You don't want to be seen as someone who was like people you used to see you in the past. So you are gathering yourself in a very different way now, and you are going to act in a different way. I'm also getting here that you're very awake and enlightened right now. Your eyes are open. You see everything very, very clearly now. This can also be someone Scorpio, like Scorpio Sun Moon Rising, that you are dealing with. This is also a situation where someone around you can be going through a lot of changes, or your entire life is shifting from one. However you used to think your life is supposed to be, it has changed completely. And you are trying to understand how to change with the change. Like you are trying to understand how to adapt to this change. Mostly this change has come about because you feel betrayed. Someone has betrayed you, or someone has left you, in a way, in the worst possible way basically. This person probably treated you in a worst possible manner. And you just feel like this cannot go on and on and on the way it has been going on till now. You are shedding this this weight that you have been carrying, and you are even losing your feathers. if you had feathers or the wings, you are losing that wing as well. Like, you don't want to be nice anymore. That's what I'm getting here. You don't want to act like an angel anymore. You want to act like someone who has like a backbone. Like, you want to be in the face of, like, you know, in, like, you want to be really, really upfront. You want to be, you want to confront people, is what I'm getting here. I'm also getting that you're very, like, people can see death in your eyes. Like, they can, one look at you, people are getting scared. Like, they, like, as if you are daring them. Like, as if you are like, do it to me once again and I'll kill you. Something of that nature. It's very weird, the messages that I'm getting right now. You feel that people have tested your patience, and that's what I'm getting here. Now let's see. I'm also getting that you are not able to let go of a heartbreak or a betrayal, and that is obstructing you from moving forward in your life. So if you are still hung up on someone who has betrayed you in the past, it's time that you let that go. I'm getting that there needs to be some movement, and there is some movement, or there is someone who is living far from you. They are traveling towards you, or you are traveling to them, or you are just communicating with this person back and forth on text or something like that, online chatting or something. But I'm getting that there is some movement, like some sort of, if things were stagnant, they have started to move, started to shift. So yes. In past you had a lot of options, or someone else had a lot of options, or you were in living in an illusion in past. So in past, probably you were not able to understand which was good, what thing was good for you and what was bad for you, and you were living in a fantasy, some of you, and you were not able to understand what is right, what is wrong, and if this person that you dealt with in the past was a good person or a bad person. You were caught up in your illusions about this person. Like, maybe you projected a lot of your good qualities on this person and you accepted this person or this situation. So this could have been, you had a lot of options, but you took like, you made a choice. Like, you know, you knew that you have a lot of options, you knew, and still you did not know which one was the right option. Right now, although you are very determined in your head, in your mind, you are very, very determined. Your soul, your spirit, and your finances, and your, you know, your drive, is everything is in balance, and you want to pursue something, and nothing is deterring your confidence. You're moving in some direction where you know, the wind is with you, the force is with you, and you can keep going on, is the message that I'm getting here. So keep moving in the direction that you have decided to move to. Now, in your future energy, you are definitely single and happy, and I think you are flaunting it that you are single and you are very happy, which is very unnatural of Scorpio. Like, Scorpio is very reserved, but I'm feeling here that you are enjoying your singlehood. You are very much in command, and you are feeling that I have earned it, and I have earned my happiness, and I'm not giving it to anyone. Like, you are valuing your yourself. Like, you know, you are valuing your time with yourself. You are valuing your moments and ideas and whatever you can create all by yourself. I'm seeing that. I'm also getting that if some of you are very alone, you are trying to create something in your lone time, in your but just by yourself, you're trying to create something, and then you are trying to materialize it, and you're wanting to sell it. So that's what I'm getting here. As soon as I said it, you are definitely trying to materialize something, and you are wanting something to you know, sell in the market, because you want to make money. You are focused on your pentacle. You are focused on something that you can build upon, something that you can start, like a company, like a business. You are definitely focused, and some of you are even trying to balance your chakras. You are very, very focused on balancing your innermost desires, and something in your core is basically cracking. I'm getting that something in your core is cracking, so that you can live your best life and you don't restrict yourself the way you have been limiting yourself in the past, is the message that I'm getting. as soon as I say that, you are definitely taking a leap of faith, or someone is taking risk on you. This person is wanting to learn something from you, or this person is wanting to spend time with you. This is a fool card. This can be you as well. You are trying to take a leap of faith. If I may say, you can be a little bit overconfident. I don't want to say that, but there is some overconfidence that I'm feeling. Maybe this is good, maybe it is not good, depending on your situation. So assess your situation really, really well. Don't be in too much of hurry. I feel that you are in a hurry with respect to a opportunity which has a possibility that it can materialize and it can become a reality, like something that was an idea or a fantasy, it can become a reality. But take your time, don't be foolish, and let's see. Okay, so this card is coming out in reverse. Usually all my cards are placed upright. This is coming out in reverse. So I'm saying, you are not assessing anything. You need to assess something. This card is about assessment. Should I invest in something or not? Is it going to be beneficial for me or not? So when it is in upright, you are doing that assessment. But when it is in reverse, you are not doing that. So I feel that you need to be very sure, where are you investing your time and money? Where are you investing your ideas and emotions? So yes, that is coming up here. And then outcome is Four of Swords. Definitely you need to heal yourself if you have been through some sort of betrayal. And you are going through some transition. Transition is not going to happen overnight. You will have to go through some rest period. You will have to give yourself space and time to do some meditation and process the feelings that you are feeling. You cannot just keep going on and on and on. You cannot just be in a work mode 24/7. You need to rest, take break, treat yourself really well, and note down things that are coming in your head, whatever that you are realizing, whatever that you are feeling, that should be written down, and that needs to be assessed. And yes, because there is a lot of passion, a lot of new ideas, something new is coming your way. I would suggest that because you're single, you can be unhinged, and you might not feel restricted, and you might do something foolish. So don't do anything foolish. That's what I'm getting here. This can be some sexual encounter as well. So you need to chill. I don't know why I need to say that. Yeah. And Five of Swords. So there can be some fight as well. If you are very, very passionate, and you can end up fighting with someone, and or talking rubbish, or being very angry with someone, which will lead to a severance of ties. Like, you can lose a friend like that if you are very passionate or hot tempered. So be mindful of that. That is also coming up. And in case definitely you have a lot of opportunities in the month of November, because I think some of you are celebrating your birthdays as well. The bottom of the deck here is the balance card. So definitely you need to keep a balance. You cannot just take one path and head over heels, just dive into it. No, maintain your balance. Everything should be done in a within the limitations. So I think I'm making this video on 16th October, so if you watch this before Halloween, I think some of the messages will resonate for Halloween. I'm getting that. You are trying to nurture someone, or someone is trying to nurture you. Someone is trying to be very, very focused on their professional or work life, is the message that I'm getting. And someone is trying to maintain a cozy home. They're cleaning their home, and while they're taking care of their work as well. I'm getting that once you were feeling restricted either by a Leo person or a Earth sign, but now you're feeling liberated in a certain capacity. You want to feel happy is what I'm getting. Let's see what are the messages coming in for Scorpio Sun Moon Rising. I know, guys, I talk really fast. that happens mostly in the Scorpio reading because I don't know, I connect with your energy so well. I'm not going to say that I I'm always correct with my readings or on point with my readings, but yeah, when I do Scorpio reading, I'm usually very fast. So yeah, excuse me if you are not able to, you know, if you don't like my reading in that sense, then you'll have to excuse me. It's not something that I do deliberately. Expansion, like I was saying, that you are expanding in a sense that whatever you have, you are trying to either manifest something or sell something or bring your ideas into material realm, or you are just expanding into a new person, like, you know, how you're becoming better than how you were in the past, and enlightenment. So your last card was about healing and almost enlightenment. Let me show you. Transformation is usually about enlightenment, by the way, and even the Fool card is a very divine card. So yes, so this card, look at the lamp here. There is a sun on its forehead, like the third eye. So there is definitely some enlightenment going on for some of you. So let me pull out one more oracle card. Messages for Scorpio for November 2018. Sun, Moon, Rising. There are three cards coming out for you, Scorpio. Visions of life beyond death. So some of you, I feel, are old soul, or you can have, like, you have a lot of intuition power or something like that, and you can see beyond the reality, and you are asking, what do you feel really? How do you really, really feel? And legacy of light. Card number 7, legacy of light. Definitely some of you are old soul here, and you are basically transitioning from one stage of your life to the the higher stage, or your higher self. So there is some transcendence that is happening, and the bottom of the deck here is the releasing allegiances. I don't know how to say that, but yeah. So guys, that was your reading. I know it was super fast. I'll see you next month. If you resonated, do drop me a comment. I'll truly appreciate it. Take care.